Hey, docs, there's been some confusion lately, and I want to clear it up. It might have even caused a problem in your practice, but I want to clear up some of the gossip around a topic, and that is we don't market and press really hard in the month of December. Having said that, we have also been invited more times this month to do stress lectures and holiday stress talks than ever. Those have been a passive byproduct and organically happened as a result of giving great care throughout the year. In our corporate Skeleton Key program, we teach CAs how to book talks. Now, we've had such great talks this year and so full. Even though I took a month off in July and I took my family to Europe, even though I took off August and we went to Maui, we still are collecting six figures every month, and we've done more stress talks in December than we've ever done. What I want to do is give you some clarity on what you can do in your stress lecture, some content to use. You see, what we teach at the Art of the Close workshop is that your content needs to be counterintuitive. And when it comes to stress, this is probably one of the easiest counterintuitive things to give. So your tip for you today, number one, is when I've been doing the lectures this month in December, I tell them the new year is coming up, and as a doctor, you're probably anticipating me telling you what to do for health in the new year. And I'm not gonna do that. In fact, I don't think you should do New Year's resolutions. Now, as I pause, I've probably got your attention. And that's what happened in my audience, seven stress lectures this month. You don't need to do New Year's resolutions. In fact, if you do them, you're gonna stress yourself out more. You're already stressed out. Now we're gonna add more things to do. You have no bandwidth to put anything else. It's gonna slow you down and stress you out. So don't do that. Do not do health resolutions this year until you've created a stop doing list. You need to stop doing some things so you have space to grow into. Part of what I mean by that is it's easy to say yes. Yes becomes your default answer. You say yes to things at school, yes to the PTO, yes, I'll help out in coaching, yes, I'll stay late at work, and pretty soon your bandwidth is maxed. Yes is an easy answer. No takes courage. So please answer this and anything else in the future as no, but let me get back to you if something opens up. No, I can't help out, but let me get back to you. And then create your stop doing list, things you're gonna delegate, drop, or just not do anymore. And then we can discuss a New Year's resolution. You see, you need space to grow into. And if you're gonna have a better, healthier, happier new year, stop doing some things, create some space in your life, and then add the healthy things into that space. So that's a soundbite from what I've been doing this month, and people freaking love it. So no, we don't do outreach. No, we don't throttle down and push the threshold on getting more, more, more. But we've had so many places contact us in December, it's real easy for me to show up and do a 10-minute talk to deliver some content like that and a little bit more. And then in a 10-minute talk, we go into our close. So listen, if you want to learn how to retire from spinal screening in the new year, and if you want to drop screenings altogether, then you need to learn to speak and grow. And the most important part of your growth, in fact, 100% of your growth comes at the last 10% of your talk, and that's the close. If you don't know how to close, you're not going to grow. 100% of your growth is represented by how you close. But the funny thing is, people don't buy you at the end of your talk. They buy you earlier in your talk, and your offer comes at the end of the talk. The emotional part of your lecture is further upstream, and the logical part is at the end. And then we crunch time and teach you to do a 10-minute talk. And nobody else is teaching this because I invented it. 10-minute talks are something I created for the chiropractic profession, and I do it every month in my practice. And I've done a lot of stress talks in 10 minutes this month of December. So get to the Art of the Close in the new year. We have one each month for the first 3 months of the year, January, February, March. They do sell out because we do them in small workshops. So I'm not pretending that we're selling out, you know, banquet halls, but we limit them to 50 people. And I have two speaking coaches that help me break this down because you need to do the work. You need to say it and articulate it so it becomes part of your vernacular. And then the results are there. I wouldn't have been on multiple continents this year teaching this if it wasn't by popular demand. I will be back in Australia in April because we sold that gig out, and then we had so many colleagues of the attendees want this info. we're coming back to Australia. So please understand, the Art of the Close workshop, the new dates are out. I will be there in the first part of the new year for Australian docs, and we'll also do something back in Europe. It's been shaking up the profession because now you can crunch time, quit spinal screening, learn to speak and grow, and if you're not closing, then your talks suck. And I know that for a fact because you give out procrastination cards. What you simply say at the end of your lecture, take a business card, suck some more, keep procrastinating, and don't come in. My friends, that isn't changing your practice. It isn't changing your family life. I took 8 weeks vacation. I know what I'm talking about. The Art of the Close. It's your answer to growth in the new year. Hope to see you at one of those workshops soon. And keep your content counterintuitive. No is the default, but you gotta say yes to the Art of the Close.